All right, so I'm gonna rebuild me a turbo 400 transmission, or try to. I've never done this before, but I have rebuilt a 4L60E, but I use the YouTube transmission bench videos, and that guy goes through everything in detail. So it was pretty easy just watching him. You just followed his steps. Now, I did add some things to the transmission that he didn't have, but now right here was your little vacuum piece. It just had a little screw and a clamp thing to hold it on, and I just unscrewed it and pulled it out, and it's over here, this piece and that piece. And then I took this out. This slides in here like this, so you just take that cover off, this cover off right here, four bolts, and this pulls out. Now, I do know you can change the weights on these. If you wanted to shift it wide open throttle without you shifting it, you can actually mess with these weights and make it shift where you want it to shift instead of having to, you know, shift it yourself. And I took the tail off. Well, this one had the bolt end shaft. I'm going with a one that slides on, uses a U. I'm going with the slides on. I don't know the nomenclature on this stuff, so all right. So I took that off, and then this piece right here, which is your speedometer, it went in this side right here. And again, it was just held on with a little C clamp and a screw. But now that was hard to pull out. I had to wind up pushing it out from the inside. And And then I just took the shifter linkage off. It's just one screw, you screw it off, it all pulls off. And then this little piece went right here. I'm assuming this is some kind of transmission temperature sensor. I'm guessing. I have no clue what I'm doing, but we're going to try it anyway. But this thing has three prongs. If you fit a wrench over it just right, it'll or a socket, if you fit a socket over it just right, it'll push them tabs in. And then I just put a screwdriver in here and ledged on that ledge there and just popped it out. And then let's see, that's about all we got. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take all this out. And I'm making this video more so I remember how to put it back together. But I'm gonna take all this linkage stuff out, this linkage stuff and this right here. And then we'll probably take the valve body off next. And then we'll pop the pump out of it. We'll take them pump bolts off and pop that out, but we got to get this stuff out first. All right, so wire piece, two screws, two bolts there, and this is the lever that you hear when you click it in gear, click 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 when you turn this. But yeah, we're gonna take all that out real quick. One thing I forgot, the pan right here, it pops right up in there, and that piece goes down in that hole. It actually pushes down inside there, but, and then there's a bolt that goes through there and goes through there, which is this bolt that holds it on. But yeah, I forgot to mention that. And that's leaking fluid everywhere. But all right, let's take this stuff out. See what we got. I took this piece out. And there's a spring under here, and got some bolts, and it goes back in just like that. The spring just goes on the other side of this lever and then just latches right there. So I'm assuming there's a notch for it to go over here as well. Yep, right there. Yeah, there's a little notch for it to go in right there, and then it just hooks right there. But all right, we got that out. I took that piece off. It was just two bolts. And then I set it over here. Yeah. Set it over there. Now, it looks like someone's been in here before, because that's a nail. They've got a nail in there holding that. Alright, so I loosen this nut up, and that give it enough room to come out of the groove on this. And hopefully, it'll give me enough room to take this out, this lever out. I took out all the bolts that had a half inch head on them. There's one there, there, there. This is where the lever went, or one of these. And that was the pan bolt, and there was one there, 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 and there. So now I'm gonna take this other size out. I believe it's a 3/8, 7/16. Yeah, I'm gonna take those out. I forgot one, there was one here, but all them bolts are the same length. I put them right there. These are the 7/16 head bolts. There's one there, there, and right here. And it looks like that thing's ready to come out. Let's see if all these are the same length. Yeah, all three of those are the same length. So there's those. So I got the valve body off. You want to be real careful when you take that off. You want to make sure the transmission's kind of flat, because there's balls in here. There's one there, one there, one there, one there, one there, and one there that I can see. And I'm going to get a magnet and take those out. And I think this pulls right out. Ooh, scraped myself with transmission fluid. And that goes in that part there. I'll take the spring out and put it. So I'm setting that all the way it came out. I think that's it for that.
Get it.
Go get it. Yep. Now let me get a magnet and take these balls out. That ethanol's what's in the car, baby. So, got one there. There, 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 and over here. So I'll just take a little magnet. Not sure if that's all of them. They don't want to let go of the magnet. That was six of them. And what I'll do is just fill this gasket back. See if any more come rolling out. I don't see any more. So that should be all of them. And we'll run the magnet across here just in case. I think I see another one. Nope. No. Nope, I don't see any more. I guess that was it. Alright, I took these six bolts out. Pulled this piece out. Put the bolts down in there. And it, this little ledge piece goes right in that area. And you can see on the gasket, the way the gasket fits that piece. It went right there. This came out in three parts. It had that piece, and this piece. So I put it, putting it back like it was, setting it in there, and you want to set it over here. But yeah, I don't know what else to take off here. Again, don't know what I'm doing. I'm just trying my best, and again, using this video so I can look back and say, how did I put that back on? But I'm gonna go ahead and try to take the pump out of it. So I'm gonna take these bolts out and pry in here with a screwdriver or something, see if I can't get that to pop out. Okay, so I got the pump bolts out, and these have washers on them, but most of the washers stayed on the pump itself. And just for future reference, I had some shield flywheel torque converter shield bolts. So if I have extra bolts, I'll remember. I took two of those out of here and here. I probably should have just left them in there. I'm cutting this ear off. When you put these in the F-body car, you got to cut the ears off. But they've already broke this one, so that works out for me. I'll just straighten it up. But I'll have to cut this one off straight down through there. But I'm going to stick a big screwdriver in there and see if I can get that to pop out. I used that screwdriver and it popped one side out, but it wouldn't pop the whole side out. So I put that big pry bar down in there and did like that. That's the only access you have, that little hole. Put it down in there and boom, popped it right out. So now the pump's out. And that should slide right out. I probably need two hands for that. But the pump goes back on this little solid piece with the retainer clip on it. Again, don't know nomenclature. Goes up this way in this hole. I was able to pull this nail out of this side. So, and then I just unscrewed this nut. It looks like the nail went in that groove and held all this in. But got all that off now. Hopefully we can pull that off far enough. There we go. Let this all come out. There we go. Got that lever out. Then we can pull this out, I'm sure. And then we can put the nut back on it. I'm gonna go ahead and pull that out real quick. That piece right there, again, I don't know what these things are called. It pulled straight out. And it looks like there's a band in there. I'm not 100% sure how to get that band out. So, probably going to go watch some YouTube videos and figure out how to get that band out of there. And the it looks like there's a pin holding that there. I wonder if a screwdriver. I don't know. Or maybe that part will just pull right out. I don't know. I'm going to go watch some YouTube videos and see if we can't figure it out. So that piece just pulled right out. And I set it over there. And then the band came out. After you got that out, the band was easy to come out. Now that piece right there, see that there's like a yellowish seal on the back of that. When you take that out, make sure you don't lose it. It like sits right there. I'm putting everything face up. So that went like that. So now, something I did forget is this, this is a bolt that holds the center section in, and that has to come out. But now, we could take this out first, but I'm gonna go ahead and take this out, and then start disassembling more of the inside. But yeah, hopefully I got a socket that'll fit in there. All right, I got that nut out. I guess you have to have a thin-walled socket to get down in there, but that 3/8 I had right there, it fit perfect. It went right down in there. And I went ahead and put that over here on my magnet with my check bolts. All right. So the next thing to take out are these clutches and plates. And to take those out, you just take this snap ring out. This snap ring goes around these grooves. You just pop that off. I'll probably have to use a couple of screwdrivers, We just pop that off, and then these clutches come out. And I'm gonna keep those in order too. And everything I set on my bench here, I'm gonna have facing up. That way I know where everything goes back in. And I'm just gonna set it all back here. Once I get all this out of here, I'm gonna set the transmission. Probably in that thing, because that's what I use to stand the transmission up to build my 4060E. I'll just have to find a different place to set that welder. And then that way I can start changing out clutches and stuff like that, and the and this drum and etc. But this one, I need to make sure it's got the 34 element sprag in it. Hopefully it does. If not, I'll have to get one from a 4L80E or order an aftermarket one. But I'm gonna take this snap ring out and take these clutches and stills out real quick. And I got those clutches and stills out, and I set them over to the side here. Now there's another snap ring. It looks like this one was about to pop out. I guess these snap rings, the opening is supposed to face this way, which if you had the transmission upright and staring down in there, it should be the 9 o'clock position, which is this way. But this one's made its way all the way over here. But we should be able to pop that out, and this whole thing should come out. All right, so that snap ring was a little bit more difficult to get out. And this one's got a bevel end on it. It was a little more difficult to get out because it's tighter in there. And also, I kept wanting to get hung up on all the other little rails in there. But this one's got a bevel on it, and the bevel went up. So remember that. All right. And once that snap rings out, that whole thing slides out of there. I think this piece comes off. I actually think I'm supposed to pull that one off first. And that's where that nut goes in that was in the case right there. But yeah. I think this comes off. Yep. I'm going to put a down there instead of these washers. I'm going to put one of those bearings in there instead of these. It's supposed to make it help. It's supposed to help, but if you put the bearing there, the case saver, losing my train of thought here. When you do the trans brake, you don't use that band that was right here. So a case saver goes right there, and I guess you gotta knock that pin out. But a case saver goes in there. And then with those things and the 34 element sprag, these things are supposed to handle 800 to 1,000 rear wheel horsepower. I'm not gonna be nowhere near that. I'll probably be, if I spray all that I wanna spray, I could be close to 900, but I don't know, 800, probably close to 800 if I sprayed 400 shot. We're at 620 right now. I'll spray another 200. It could get up to 800, give or take. But after you get all that out of there, there's the, I guess that's the reverse band. And you just pull that out, I think. Hey, wait, there's another. There's another snap ring there on the bottom. I didn't notice that one. That one comes out easy. And then now maybe that'll come out. And we'll put that right there. Yeah, I'm probably gonna have to have two hands to pull that out, but pretty sure That pulls right out. And that's pretty much it, man. That's the disassembly of the, well, let me get that out first. All right, it's out, it's disassembled. Now, actually, I guess I didn't need to take all this linkage crap out. And this is the lockout for park. So when you put it in park, you know how it locks. Ah, there ain't no need taking that off. And I guess there wasn't no sense putting the, taking the lever off. So I may go ahead and put that back in, but I'm gonna take this thing and put some oven cleaner on it and take it to the car wash, spray it off real good, get this gasket material off. And I'm gonna take that drum apart right there and see what drum that is and if there's a sprag in it, 34 element sprag, if there is. I'm set, I just need that Torrington bearing and a case saver, and then get a rebuild kit and a trans brake, and start tossing it back together. And then we'll need a stall converter and a drive shaft, and that's about it. But yeah, we'll get her cleaned up, get the parts ordered, check, see what's in that, and then go from there. But that's tearing apart a turbo 400.